Welcome to another training session. In today's session, we are going to see how we can make a hold-on circuit for a relay or contactor. And we will discuss how does a hold-on circuit works. Before starting, I would like you guys to please subscribe to my channel to stay connected with me for some amazing upcoming video tutorials. Let's start today's session. First, we have to understand how does a normal open push button works. Normal open push button have a normal open contacts. If we press the normal open push button, its NO contact closes. And if we release the push button, its NO contacts opens again. Now let's understand the normal open push button more with an example by putting normal open push button in series with bulb and a power source. Here, if we keep press the push button, it will close the NO contacts. And current path completes and current starts to flow through the circuit and the bulb turns on. If we release the push button, it will open up again the NO contacts and current path breaks and current stops to flow through the circuit and bulb turns off. Now let's see how does a normal closed push button works. It's exactly opposite to the normal open push button. The normal closed push button have NC or normal closed contacts. Let's put a normal closed push button in series with bulb and a power source. The bulb turns on because of the NC contact of the push button. If we keep press the push button, the bulb turns off as the NC contact of the push button opens and cuts the path of the current to flow. If we release the push button, the NC contact closes again and current starts to flow and bulb turns on. So basically normal open and normal close push buttons works exactly the opposite way. Now let's come to our main topic for the today's tutorial, how we can use normal open and normal close contacts to make a hold on circuit. First we need 24 volt power. We will take positive wire and through normal close push button we will connect it to the normal open push button. From the output of the normal open push button, we will connect a wire to the A1 terminal of the contactor. A2 terminal is connected to the negative 24 volt DC. A1 and A2 are the terminal of the coil of the contactor. If we apply 24 volt DC at A1 and A2, it will turn on. Now, if we keep press the normal open push button, the current flows through the normal close and normal open push button and reaches A1 terminal of the contactor. It will energize the contactor as long as the green push button is keep pressed, which is normal open push button. If we release the green push button, its NO contacts opens and thus current stops to flow in the circuit and the contactor turns off. In the next step, we will see how to modify the wiring so that if the green normal open push button is pressed once, the contactor keeps turned on, and then even if we release the green push button, the contactor kept hold on. For this, we will connect a wire from the output NC contact of the red push button to the normal open auxiliary contact of the contactor. And from the other end of the normal open auxiliary contact of the contactor to the A1 terminal. Now let's test again the circuit. If we press the green push button, the current flows through the circuit and contactor turns on. But now if we release the green push button, the contactor stays turned on. Let's see why this contactor is now latched on. Once the contactor turned on by pressing the green push button, its normal open auxiliary contact closes. This makes another path for the current to flow and the current starts to flow from the normal closed push button to normal open auxiliary contact of the contactor. And as this auxiliary contact is now closed, the current flows through this contact and reach A1 terminal. This way the contactor gets latched on and stay on. Now, the only way to turn off the contactor is to press the red push button, which is normal close push button. Once we press the red push button, its normal close contact opens, thus cuts the power supply to the whole circuit and the contactor turns off. So that's how we can use the normal open and close push buttons to hold on a relay or a contactor. I hope we have learned something in this video tutorial. Please do consider subscribing my channel, and until next video, take care and goodbye.